Word on the Run with Pastor Marius Wagt.
Beloved, welcome to Word on the Run. We are in 50 days to Pentecost, and we are in day 21 of our 50 days to Pentecost. We are busy speaking about the prerequisites. We've spoken about the person of the Holy Spirit. We've spoken about the promise of the Holy Spirit. Now we are speaking about the prerequisites for the baptism in the Holy Spirit. And we've dealt with six of them, and the seventh one is prayer. That you and I will pray, that we ask and will keep on asking for the grace of God. Now, if the Bible says, if you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven not give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? Luke 11, verse 13. So God is actually saying to us, and Jesus is actually saying, if we know how to give good gifts to our children, how much more will the Holy Spirit not be given to us if we ask him? But that's the prerequisite. We need to ask. We need to pray. Now, the Amplified version of Matthew 7 from verse 7 to 11 is this. He says, keep on asking and it will be given to you. Keep on seeking and you will find. Keep on knocking and the door will be opened. He says, for everyone who keeps on asking receives, and everyone who keeps on seeking finds, and everyone who keeps on knocking, the door will be opened. And then he says, oh, what man is there of you, if his son asks him of a loaf of bread, will hand him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will hand him a serpent? If then, evil as you are, you ask, how much more will God not give you good and advantageous gifts? And he says, he will not give to those who keep on asking him. Those who keep on asking him, those who keep on seeking him, those who keep on knocking, they will receive. Now, the reasons why our prayers are not answered and it doesn't get answered is sometimes for the following reasons. Firstly, because we don't pray, we don't seek, and we don't knock. And that's why James 4 verse 2 says, you don't receive because you do not ask. Now, Psalm 2 verse 8 says, ask of me and I will give you. Ask of me and I will give you. James chapter 1 verse 5 says, even if we need wisdom, we must ask of God, who gives liberally to all who ask him. Now, a second reason is sometimes we are selfish in our reasons. What is the reason why I want to be baptized in the Holy Spirit? What is the reason? Do I seek it for my own sake? Do I seek it just for speaking in tongues sake? Or do I seek it so that I can be used by God? So you do ask, says the Bible in James 4, 3. He says, you do ask and yet fail to receive because you ask with wrong purpose and evil, selfish motives. So you and I need to ask for the right reasons. Even Acts 8, verse 18 to 19, there we see how there was asked to receive the Holy Spirit for the wrong and selfish reasons. And therefore, you and I must have the right motives, and we must have the right reasons why we asking for the baptism in the Holy Spirit. Another reason is we don't put God's kingdom first. And that's what we are taught in Matthew 6:33. He says, first ye seek ye the kingdom of God, and all these other things shall be added unto you. So we need to put God's kingdom first, and then we will receive everything that God has promised us and want us to have. Another reason is we doubt. We don't believe. We doubt. And because we doubt, because we don't believe, and the Bible says in James 1 verse 6, it says, when you ask him, be sure that you really expect him to answer, for a doubtful mind is as unsettled as a wave of the sea that is driven and tossed by the wind. And Hebrews 11 verse 6 says, without faith it is impossible to please God, but he who comes to God must believe that God exists and that he is a rewarder of their faith. and that he's a rewarder of those who earnestly seek him. So you and I need to ask in faith. We need to believe, and we mustn't doubt, because then we are double-minded men, and double-minded men can't expect to receive anything from God, says the Word of God. Now, God has promised, and the promises regarding our praise is this in Matthew 6, verse 6. He says this to us. He says, when you pray, go into your private room and closing the door, pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you in the open. Now, that's what the baptism in the Holy Spirit is. The baptism in the Holy Spirit happens in public, but it is what has happened inside you and what has happened in your heart that is now being revealed, and that brings faith to those who see what happens to you. So John 15 verse 7 says, if you live in me and my word remain in you and continue to live in your hearts, ask whatever you will and it shall be done to you. So you and I need to know that's God's promise. He says another one, I assure you, most solemnly I tell you, that my Father will grant you whatever you ask in my name, says John 16, 23. God also promises there in Luke 11, 13, he says, how much more will your Father in heaven not give you the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? That's God's promise. All you need to do is ask him, seek him, and you will find. Let us pray. Father God, I pray for people that will ask and keep on asking. I pray for people who will seek and keep on seeking, and I pray for people who will knock and keep on knocking until they have received. You are a God of your promise. You are not a man that you should lie, or man child that you should regret what you said. You will give to us everything that you promised. And Lord, I pray the Holy Spirit is being called the Holy Spirit of promise, and I pray that those people who do what you want them to do, they fulfill the prerequisites, that they will receive the baptism in the Holy Spirit. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.